Today we are going to discussing about the upcoming range of motion with the goniometry. First of all, we are starting with the solar flexion. For the solar flexion, flexion position supine line, less the fulcrum over the greater tuberosity, stable, movable arm parallel to the lateral aspect of the arm, and stable arm is straight to the movable arm. Now ask the patient to move your hand forward and upward towards the ear. Normal range of motion for the shoulder flexion is the 180 degrees. For the shoulder extension, patient position prone lying, fulcrum placed over the greater tuberosity, movable arm parallel to the lateral aspect of the arm, and stable arm straight to the movable arm. Now ask the patient to raise your head towards the ceiling. Now for the shoulder abduction, patient position is a supine lying, fulcrum placed over the acromion process, movable arm parallel to the anterior aspect of the arm, and stable arm placed horizontally over the clavicle. Now ask the patient to move your arm away from the body. Normal range of motion for the shoulder abduction is 180 degrees. Now for the shoulder rotation, patient position supine lying, shoulder abducted 90 degrees and elbow flexed 90 degrees. Fulcrum placed over the olecranon process, movable arm parallel to the middle aspect of the forearm and stable arm perpendicular to the ground. Internal rotation, ask the patient to move your arm down towards the feet. Now for the external rotation, ask the patient to move your hand down towards the head. Patient position supine lying with palm facing towards the ceiling. Now place the fulcrum over the lateral epicondyle of the humerus. Stable arm parallel to the midline of the lateral aspect of the arm, and movable arm parallel to the midline of the lateral aspect of the forearm. Ask the patient to bend your elbow. Normal range for the elbow flexion is 145 degrees. For the elbow extension, patient position supine lying with elbow fully flexed. Fulcrum placed over the lateral epicondyle of the humerus. Stable arm placed over the midline of the lateral aspect of the arm, and movable arm placed over the midline of the lateral aspect of the forearm. Now ask the patient to straight your arm. For elbow extension, normal range of motion is 145 to 0 degrees.
For supination, patient position sitting on a table, forearm in mid prone position and supported over the table, fulcrum at ulnar spiral process, stable arm parallel to the ground, movable arm a dorsal aspect of wrist. Now ask the patient to rotate your forearm that palm faces towards ceiling. Normal range of supination is 80 degrees. For pronation, patient position sitting on a table, forearm in mid prone position and supported over the table. Fulcrum at ulnar spiral process, stable arm parallel to the ground and movable arm at the anterior aspect of wrist. Now ask the patient to rotate your forearm that palm faces toward the floor. Normal range of pronation is 90 degrees. For wrist flexion, patient position sitting on a chair, forearm pronated and resting on the table. Fulcrum position at ulnar spiral process, stable arm, medial aspect of the forearm and movable arm parallel to the little finger. Ask the patient to move your head down towards floor. Normal wrist flexion is 80 degrees. Extension, patient position sitting on a chair, forearm pronated and resting on plane. Fulcrum position at ulnar spiral process, stable arm, parallel to the medial aspect of forearm and movable arm parallel to the little finger. Now ask the patient to move your hand towards ceiling. Extension is 70 degrees. For radial deviation, patient position sitting on a table, forearm pronated and supported over the table, fulcrum position, mid part of wrist joint, stable arm, in midline of posterior aspect of forearm, movable arm, in a line with middle finger. Now ask the patient to move your hand towards thumb. Normal range of radial deviation is 20 degrees. For ulnar deviation, patient position in sitting on a chair, forearm supported over the table and pronated, fulcrum position at middle part of wrist joint, stable arm, midline of dorsal aspect of forearm and movable arm in line of middle finger. Now ask the patient to move your hand towards little finger. Normal range of ulnar deviation is 45 degrees.
Position of the patient sitting on a table with forearm and palm fully resting in midfoot position. Position of the fulcrum over the dorsal aspect of metacarpophalangeal joint. Position of the stable arm over the midline of dorsal aspect of the respective metacarpal. Position of the movable arm over the midline of dorsal aspect of respective phalanx. Ask the patient to bend your finger towards your palm as much as you can. Normal range of metacarpophalangeal joint flexion is 0 to 90 degrees. Metacarpophalangeal joint extension. Position of the patient sitting on a chair with forearm and palm fully resting on a supported surface in palm in midfront position. Position of the fulcrum over the dorsal aspect of metacarpophalangeal joint. Position of the stable arm over the dorsal midline of respective metacarpal. Position of the movable arm over the midline of dorsal aspect of respective phalanx.
Start.
Now ask the patient to bend your finger away from your palm as much as you can.
Normal range of metacarpophalangeal joint is 0 to 45 degrees. Metacarpophalangeal joint adduction. Position of the patient sitting on the chair with forearm and palm fully resting in pronation. Position of the fulcrum over the dorsal aspect of metacarpophalangeal joint. Position of the stable arm over the dorsal midline of respective metacarpal. Position of the movable arm over the midline of dorsal aspect of respective phalanx.
Ask the patient to move your finger towards midline.
Normal range of metacarpophalangeal joint adduction is variable. Metacarpophalangeal joint abduction.
Position of the patient sitting on a chair with forearm and palm to the resting in pronation. Position of the fulcrum over the dorsal aspect of metacarpophalangeal joint. The stable arm over the midline of dorsal aspect of respective metacarpal. Position of the movable arm over the midline of dorsal aspect of respective phalanx. Ask the patient to move your finger away from midline or middle finger. Normal range of metacarpophalangeal joint abduction is variable. Metacarpophalangeal joint flexion. Position of the patient sitting on a chair with forearm and palm fully resting in a mid-bone position. Position of the fulcrum over the dorsal aspect of interphalangeal joint. Position of the stable arm over the midline of dorsal aspect of proximal phalanx and position of the movable arm over the midline of dorsal aspect of middle phalanx.
Ask the patient to bend your finger towards your palm. Go.
Normal range of interphalangeal joint flexion is more than 100 degrees.
Ask the patient to take your finger away from your palm.
Go.
Normal range of interphalangeal joint extension is 45 degrees to 0. Carpometacarpal joint flexion. Position of the person sitting on a table with forearm and palm fully resting into supination. Position of the fulcrum over the inter aspect of carpometacarpal joint. Position of the movable arm over the palmar aspect of first metacarpal bone. Position of the stable arm over the palmar aspect of radius.
Oh. Ask the patient to move your thumb towards your little finger.
Go.
Normal range of carpometacarpal joint flexion is 0 to 50 degrees. Carpal joint extension. Position of the patient sitting on a chair with forearm and palm fully resting in full supination. Position of the fulcrum over the palmar aspect of first carpometacarpal joint. Position of the stable arm over the mentor aspect of radius. Position of the movable arm over the mentor aspect of first metacarpal bone.
Ask the patient to move your thumb away from your palm.
Normal range of carpometacarpal joint extension is 0 to 15 degree. Carpometacarpal joint abduction. Position of the patient sitting on a table with forearm and palm fully resting in mid-bone position. Position of the fulcrum over the lateral aspect of radius sidereal process. Position of the stable arm over the lateral aspect of second metacarpal bone. Position of the movable arm over the lateral aspect of first metacarpal bone.
Ask the patient to move your thumb towards your palm in a horizontal plane.
Normal range of carpometacarpal joint abduction is 0 to 70 degrees.